Okay, we're going to look at the next question. It's actually question 4.2, the 2019 Fishhook High School grade 10 final exam. That is the function part of it. Since you guys have a test coming up on functions, we're going to look at this one. Now, this is the one that's a bit more challenging. It's not just graph the functions. In this one, you're given two functions. You're told one is called function f, and the other one's called function g. Now, one is in the form a to the x plus q, and the other one's in the form of b over x plus q. Well, hey, they both have a q here. They actually share the same thing. Both of these functions have things called asymptotes. Asymptotes. That's a line that helps define the function. Well, this one, when you see the little x as a power, that's called an exponential function. And maybe you know this red line. It starts off from the asymptote, there's the asymptote, and it takes off like that. Oh, well, that means that this function must be f. And the other function with two branches, look, it has x in the denominator. Whenever you see x in the denominator, that's a hyperbola. Whenever you see x in the as an exponent, it's an exponential equation. Okay, now, the first thing they do is they say, use the graph to determine q. Okay, that's q right there. Oh, that's the same for both of them. That's this horizontal asymptote. Well, that number there's minus 2. It's minus 1. I'm looking at it. So it's so easy. It's just y equals minus 1. So q must be minus 1 because that's the flat horizontal asymptote that defines the hyperbola, and it's the one that's the horizontal asymptote that the exponential equation is kind of taken off from. Then it says, well, now we know that q is minus 1, and f of x is really y. And now we're going to use this equation, y equals a to the x. Now we know q is minus 1. Use a point to determine a algebraically. We're going to try that. Use a point to determine a algebraically. Well, a point that's given in the picture. Well, this 2 is given for x, and this 3 is given for y. So 2 along and 3, that fits into this exponential equation. So that's all you do. You know, so many of these questions work the same way in grade 10 and 11. All you do is you take the function that you've got, and instead of x, you put in a 2. And instead of y, you put in a 3. And that's all there is to it. Well, you have, instead of x, it's a 2, so it's a squared, and y is really 3. You add 1 to both sides, 3 plus 1 is 4. Now we've got a squared is equal to 4. Well, instead of thinking about it as 4, why not let it look, make it look like 2 squared? 2 times 2 is. Now I can see, if I make the exponents exactly the same, these bases must be the same for it to be equal. So a must equal 2. Okay, I think we'll split that up because the video will be just too long if we keep on going on here with this one. But this whole idea of taking a point and then using your equation, there's your y and there's your x, and substituting in the x value, the 2 goes in here for x, and the 3, which is the y value, the 3 goes in right here. And that's it. Then it looks like this, and then you solve the equation. So many questions work like that. Okay.